I got a mosquito bite on my leg and it's getting annoying.
What happened?
I got a mosquito bite. Good day, people. We are now on. And now we can record this. So, it's time for a story time. Are you ready for story time, Sean?
Slightly.
Okay, so what had happened was this man over here, this Crono, decided I was going to get the EV box because I had the money to do it. And I wanted to, because for more codes, because I'm a sucker for codes. And I told Mike I wanted one, so he pulls up the box that he has the others in, because he had a lot more of the Eevee box, the Shiny Bay box for Eevee. And then Chris...
gets six of them.
He had six of them. Chris goes up to one, which is like, this was like on the left side in the middle. He goes up and goes... and I'm like, fuck, now I have to get that. And then I'm like, wait... and then Mike's like, no. He's like, no, you don't. And I'm like, okay, fine. I won't get it then. And then he comes back again and goes, touched it twice. I'm like, okay, now I have to. Now I have to. So I got this one that he touched twice. We open a pack. I let him open one. I open one. And I let Mikey pick one. We open the two Charizard ones. Okay. I didn't get anything really. I got like a reverse holo, a couple cards, but I didn't really get anything. I'll show you which ones I pulled. He didn't really get anything. The one that Mikey pulls, he, because Chris touched it twice.
Mike said, oh no.
He said, oh no, and I got these two.
Oh!
Zoom in. Zoom in.
Oh!
Rainbow art, rainbow foil, rainbow rare here. Of Toxic.
Rainbow Toxic.
Rainbow rare. Shiny Toxic Eevee. And Cinderace. Full art.
You have a Cinderace.
I have a Cinderace. But this. This.
Yes,
he touched it twice.
Shining Fates, yes?
This is Shining Fates, yes.
My lordy.
Anyways, fucking
are you
rainbow
not entertained?
Rare. Are you not amused?
Okay, see, this is the thing I love about Pokemon. They have printed so many of these cards, even those really pretty ones are cheap.
Yeah, see, coughing more Pico Horsey.
Actually, that Tox is the one I'm curious about.
Yeah, the rainbow rare Toxicity.
Because he.
Because
he's technically
look at it.
Okay.
Lore.
$5 market value.
Really? Yeah. They're not really that expensive. It's the Charizard. Sorry about that.
Yeah, $150 for that boyo.
Yeah.
You didn't open all her packs yet.
No, not yet. But more Pico. I don't have a downward facing cam, so I don't have a second one. I'm not a drive great. Then,
So you learned how to put the good ones at the back?
Yeah. No, that's how they come in like that. Ball guy. Corvant. Twacky. And, yeah, that's it for that one. This was the pack, yeah, that both Toxicity Tree and Cinderace came out of.
That's impressive as all get out.
Fucking rainbow rare on my first freaking box. Or at least the box of Shining Fates. Are you fucking kidding me?
That's really good, though. That's really, really good.
I opened a thing of Battle Styles when I was there. I'm gonna separate the code cards, because then I can get...
I gave her all my online codes.
Mikey gave me, like, a shit ton, too.
Did he really?
Yeah, and he threw this pack in for me on the house. I love him so much sometimes. That guy is so cool.
The guy's amazing.
He is. That's why I will always buy my cards from that dude. Okay, so...
if I could, I would, but, you know, I got Gaming Goat, so gotta support them.
I mean, we always make a run when you come.
Yeah,
down
we
here.
Will. We make a run for when you're here. So.
Oh yeah.
And you hour. Did good last time, Sean. When I poke you, like you take these last two packs and keep going.
Keep going.
No, it was ridiculous.
So, look at tongue. Another horsey. I love horsey so much. Hanky spanky manky. I have a versatile.
Cheryl. I like her.
Stonejourner. I think I think this is the one you're gonna have. In sword, because I have the other one in shield. I don't think I have Stonejourner in shield. Unless I'm wrong, I don't know. I can't remember. I think this is steel energy or dark energy now.
Dark energy.
This is dark?
Yeah.
Okay. I have a Pignite.
Hey, you have the buffet Pignite. There's a few different arts of those. You have the fun one.
The very pissed off, angry, hangry Borpeko.
Why is he angry?
Because he's always hangry. Yeah, that was it. And then back to Silicobra. And that was a battle style spec.
I don't remember Morpeko being angry.
He has the normal mode, happy mode, and a hangry mode.
Oh jeez.
He switches it in battle each turn. He'll go from hangry to he'll go from happy to hangry.
That's funny.
He's an unhappy little shit. Alright, and then this was the revolving wild pack that I had open. Oh, there's a card. Or there's a code card that I have to go. That.
Forgive me if
I just realized something.
Huh?
Yes.
For fake go, if you target the class banner when it's
Pop
up,
it.
And keep calling the same unit, you could get more.
This was
get a USO quicker.
He's a common.
Keep pulling the same unit over and over.
He's a common, but it was a reverse holo Hippopotamus.
Which is
Hippopotamus. I never could pronounce this Pokemon's name. It's Hippopotas. 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 Somebody wanna fucking? If you know how to fucking say this name, give me a shout. My rare was the Altaria.
Oh, you got one of the rare dragon types.
I love Altaria so much. And then, of course, fighting energy. A Vigoroth. Scroll the flying dragon. Yes.
The scrolls are very interesting cards.
You know what, the fact that I have that Shining Fates box and now I have a box to put all my Pokemon cards in? And now...
I knew I should have sent the other ones. I knew I should have sent the box that you had me get you sooner.
Right on it. Let me fix my cam. I'm sorry, everybody. This is my first time actually using my camera, so I'm a little camera shy. I swear I'm just ugly as fuck. No, this isn't wine. This is, juice. Actually, decadently, it's a Stella Rosa non-alcoholic wine, and it slaps.
Stella Rosa makes non-alcoholics.
Dude, it's fucking good. It's the rosé flavor.
Since when?
I love Stella Rosa. They're really good, but I think I'm actually really allergic to it. Because when I drink it, my face gets red. Like, stupidly red. Like
That doesn't mean you're allergic. Like, does anything tingle?
No, but, I mean, I still get, like, reaction to it. Doesn't have to tingle.
No, like, your face becoming flush just means there's, blood rush.
It just goes... like...
What, does it, your like, face swell, or...?
No, it feels hot. And I barely sipped it. And it's usually when I drink Stella Black, though. And I really like that one.
Okay, there's a Shellder in this lake. That's neat.
Sorry, I can't help it. Every time I hear shoulder, I have to do it. Okay, so coffee.
I'm gonna run out of Pokeballs before I get through this place.
Cacnea,
it's just the starting zone.
It is Legacyfleur. Okay, and before we get far into this, the reason why I'm redoing this again is because story time. I have come to find out that a box that I had from my old room in Colorado when we were moving, I had put my scrapbook in there that my guardian made me when I was a kid, when I was still growing up in the group home, because I was a foster kid, for about 7 years. My Lisa Frank binder, I was really into that, you know, Lisa Frank shit when I was a kid, like the only really girly thing I was ever into was that, because I thought they were cool. I had a binder that had all my Pokemon cards in it. And then the jewelry box that Ben got me and my sister Julie when I was still in junior high was in that box, and they were like gone now. And like a box of paintings that Ben's mom did for a house. Those two boxes never made it to California.
Oh god.
So my entire collection of Pokemon cards that I had when I was a kid is gone. There's only one card that I vividly remember that I think is like $8 on TCG Player that I'm just gonna order again because it was my favorite card. It was a Japanese holo Togetic. Because I like Gen 2 a lot. Gen 2 is my favorite. So having Togetic was cool. And it came from somebody who was actually Japanese. So another one of my housemates before he was taken back by his parents. He gave me that card. Because he was a friend of mine. I actually remember his name, too. His name was Taiichi, and wherever you are, dude, hope you're happy. He was really cool. He was a cool kid. Cool Japanese kid. I never understood why his mom's face was so shiny when she was, like, so oily. Oh, man.
Ah! What ran into me?
I got a snom-nom.
What the hell is that?
What, snom?
Yeah.
Only, like, the best ice-type bug ever. You'll see this in the ice area. Nom Nom is good. It has, like, one of the coolest hidden abilities. I think it's called Ice Scales. But it's just cute! And I call it just look at his face! It's a Snom Nom! His name is Snom. And then...
It's one of those things that I see getting a plush for Kiwi for.
Chirping.
What the hell is that? Oh, it's a pit of... Go away, ugly pigeon.
And then reverse holo coughing. So I got two coughings in this one. But this one's a reverse holo.
That's kind of neat.
My rare in this was the Yamanga. Then water energy, a ball guy. And my uncommon was a float soul.
Oh, I will. Okay. Team Yelp. So. The Buizel and the Buizel family is a bit of a soft spot for me.
I love Buizel so much. They were my favorite water type in a... They were from Sinnoh, right? Yeah, they were Sinnoh.
Yeah.
They were like, my favorite
water. I know they're not...
I cannot wait to have it back on my team when the remakes came out. Which will there will be playthroughs of that once I get my Elgato card back from Aaron.
Like, I know it's not a particularly good Pokemon, but I loved it to bits.
Have you seen this little cutie yet?
I have a Nickit on my team.
I love Nickit so much. It's so cute.
He's terrible.
I don't care if he's terrible. He's cute as hell.
He is. He is, but no, that's what happened to him. Like, he got poked once by something and he lost half his health and I'm like, ugh.
Well, then you got a really crap one. You didn't try hard enough. Horsey.
He was level 11, everything else in the area was level 8, and he was just falling over like a sack of used potatoes.
He probably has like shit for attack IVs.
I know, he's got, yeah, no, it's defense IVs.
Oh, so he has shit for defense IVs. What's his image? Yeah, what's his nature?
I think I already moved him to the box. You're fucking... That's right. No, hear me out. I moved him to the box for a level 20 Natu. I've gotten a Dynamax raid early on.
I love that.
Exactly.
I like its sound mace, just it's so happy. Look how happy this Morpeko is. See, you want it to look like that.
And yes, I do.
You want it to feed it.
Yes, I'd be happy to feed it if he was happy.
Another Cacnea. And then here's my second horsey, but it was reverse holo horsey.
Okay,
I liked the reverse holo treatment just because I liked the actual, like...
I never knew there was such thing as a reverse holo. That wasn't around when we were kids.
No, reverse holos didn't exist. You had shadowless... You had regular and shadowless foil. And the shadowless foil was considered the defect.
Man, I never knew. I just knew it was a holo. It was holographic if I had one. I didn't know the difference between that. I just went, oh, I have a holo card. Look how cool I am. Because if you had a holo card, that shit was flexing. Especially if they were shadow Pokemon. And I had shadow holos.
Well, here's the thing. If you found a shadowless holo Raichu, that one's even rarer than Charizard. So technically, he's worth more.
You know what really sucks, though? Is, like, I know some of... I had some of those Charizards. I don't know if it was the Charizard that I had was that one that people want.
Oh, you mean the first edition one that's worth 300k?
Yeah. I can't remember if it was.
It's a Pancham. I have to get this.
That's actually really funny. My adopted mom, she showed me a picture of a Pancham. And because it was, I guess it was for my niece or something like that. And she's like, what character is this, Shell? And I'm like, his name is Pancham. It's on the tag. Because the tag is right there. My adopted mom, I adore her. But sometimes I swear this woman has, like... I don't know anymore, man. My rare...
Perception minus 5.
Yeah. My rare was a Volcanion. Which is cool.
That is nice.
Damn. 120 damage for each heads. Imagine if you get heads twice when you flip 2 coins.
Yeah, please no.
Yeah, please yes. More fighting energy. Another float soul that I love. My common was a Tropius. And then I have Gym Trainer. So you draw 2 cards. If any of your Pokemon were knocked out during your opponent's last turn, draw 2 more cards.
Dude, I'm about to use up all my Pokeballs. I'm about to have 0 Pokeballs because I've been catching everything in the starting zone.
Why don't... Stop catching things in the starting zone then! Did you get a Rookidee?
There... Yes.
Carbonite's kick ass.
Fight a Rufflet. Well, wait. I'm lying. I do want to fight a Rufflet because I want to get the items that it drops from the Dynamax raid. Because of course I want
to
fight it.
You need to get the expansion packs. They're like $60 for both, I think.
30.
30. Okay. 30. Is it 30 for 2?
Or the 30 for one of them. But I just need the one.
You need both.
Well, no, it gives you both.
Okay, I didn't know if it gave you both.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm retarded. Yeah. Since you're playing mine, finally. Okay, so before we open the Pokemon cards, first we're gonna open...
Oh, did you finish opening all the...
No, I didn't. I was gonna wait to do this. Because I wanted to stream it, and I wanted to record it.
Oh, wait, I thought it was a Rufflet.
Did you open all the shiny fates?
No, I didn't.
No, okay.
I told you, I was going to wait for you guys. First, we're going to open the one pack of Modern Horizons. I did not pay for any of these because I traded Mikey some of my cards that I pulled out of my half of the MH2 box. $30. It was worth it. And then, you know, I bought that box for myself, but I traded for the... For my some of my Evolving Sky packs and this magic pack, I traded some of the MH2 stuff. That
box are all 150 here. It was at 130, but then jumped.
Sean. So if PayPal doesn't... How does PayPal not work for you?
No, my account is locked.
What did you do? Buy
no.
cocaine on the black
someone,
market?
No, someone broke in and used my account.
Oh, just make a new one, then.
Yeah, probably gonna have to. I'm gonna have to use Gmail or something.
Yeah, use your Gmail. Because if I'm gonna have you buy stuff from Gaming Goat for me, especially that Evolving Wild box, I have to pay you.
Why can't... Oh, that's right. Venmo went to crap at a basket.
I hate Venmo. Okay, so I have a Lightning Sphere. Our normal's so shiny. I love the squirrel. It's so cute. It's like,
ooh, shiny.
Yeah, ooh, shiny.
Why did I catch that? Beast new
lash claw. I have a serious charger. It's pretty much a pissed off Pegasus.
Actually, it does say Pegasus as its type, yeah?
Absolutely. Looks like its chicken wings are like, it's losing its feathers on its chicken wings. Huh. Piercing rays. Except the tapped creature. Forecast. Reveal piercing rays from your hand. Tap a target. Tap a target. Untapped creature. The forecast calls for pain.
So how can I tell when a Pokemon's gonna fall from a tree?
It'll fall on your head. Yeah?
No, like...
Yeah. I don't want you to forget again, so I don't want to wake up to a bunch of ants. I'm going to bed.
Good night. Or say good night.
Good night.
Be gone.
Wow.
We said goodnight.
I did. I told you. I told her she said goodnight, and she said goodnight back.
Okay.
Yay.
We were like, what?
Fucking children, I swear. Okay, so I got Tingle Bridge.
Here, Choodle. You.
It's an artifact land. It's an indestructible artifact land.
They all are.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, that was one of those special properties they gave them. They made all the artifact lands from MH2 indestructible. Which I thought was kind of nice. But that's because they also slightly brought back Affinity.
Diahannes Plume.
That's a Vileplume. I probably should not be fighting that.
Vileplume.
What's this guy?
Dark Moss Bridge. Another artifact land. That's cool.
Dark. That's the green black. That's good.
Ooh. Put that in Charter Bank if I ever needed another one. Arcbound Mouser.
Dude, I love the modular creatures. I love the Arcbound stuff.
I have a Foop. I'm so glad I caught the cards before I caught the pack, because that went bye bye. Almost fell. I have a Foundry Helix.
That's a Hoot Hoot, that's a Nuzleaf.
Hey, Hoot Hoot's amazing, you shut up.
No, I'm just making note of what I'm seeing around me.
Oh, okay. I have a Barbed Spike. Reminds me of a Thopter almost, but it's not.
It does kind of look Thopterish, doesn't it?
It does look a little Thopterish. I have a Flame Tongue Yearling sketch card.
I do like the sketch cards. I know a lot of people don't like them, but I think they're neat.
Chancellor.
God, that's so creepy.
Yeah, I know he's creepy, huh? Lazotep Chancellor. I have a Flame Rift, but I don't know why it has that weird stamp on it.
Oh, okay. So let me explain those.
Please do. You are the resident magic nerd.
What you're seeing is a throwback stamp. That means that is an older set card given a new reprint.
Thank you.
Yes, and I think that one is Torment.
Oh, I've got an Obsidian Charma as my rare, or whatever the gold one is.
Yeah, could have been worse.
Gold is rare, right? Silver is uncommon.
Correct.
And then Squirrel Token.
Squirrels.
Yes, because Chatfin exists and he makes me happy and does great works. 1 second, I'm going to get that. Where is it? Easy my foot to get the pack. Because I have monkey toes.
Wait, Zigzagoon found another item. You found me a free poke at all. Oh my god, I love you, thank you.
So you have the Galarian one where it looks like it's a freaking rock star?
Yeah, he's going to be Gene Simmons when he grows up.
You're going to name him Gene Simmons?
No.
You know the best part of the fact that when Gene Simmons actually saw that, he did not sue the UK for that?
No. My favorite thing was that he's like, this thing looks tight, and then suddenly everyone wanted Sword and Shield because he said it was cool. You could not get better free advertising if you tried.
Wait, yeah, you can. Oh, no. I hate it when my thing goes out like that. It really bugs me.
Oh, when the focus just decides it doesn't want to.
Yes, and I don't even have autofocus on anymore because I turned it off. This thing sucks sometimes when it does that, and it's supposed to be the really good webcam.
Okay, so was Nuzleaf a grass and fighting type? What's its shtick?
Nuzleaf?
Because it has grass, like a...
I think it is a grass and fighting. I don't remember.
It's got like a little fighter pose. So
okay,
I'm like,
so should we open the Shining Fates packs or should we open the new packs for the one that just came out? Shining Fates, because Evolving Skies is a new one.
Yeah, let's open the box that you started working on. Let's see that good
finish
stuff.
Finish what we started.
Yeah, okay.
that's the right way to put
Rainbow
it.
Or Dragavolt right now.
I mean, if you do, you're going back, right?
I know that I have to give something to Chris. His he'll just end up getting those fetch lands that I pulled.
And I think I'm down to 2 Pokeballs now that I caught that Nuzleaf.
Can you stop catching everything?
No, there's too much good stuff here. I can build a really good team with this.
Look, it's gotta catch them all. It's gotta be, he's gotta do it.
He can't catch them all. There's over like 800. Not all of them are in that game, which makes me mad.
They gave me a lot to work with, though.
I'm thinking also that I have a working theory of why they chose the 25th to make, Sinnoh remakes.
Ooh, okay. Go on.
This is just my theory on why. I think it's because with the dying of the 3DS, Sinnoh was the only one that was able to hold all the current Pokemon up until today. So they need another game way to. They need another outlet game for people to put their Pokemon in that would be trapped inside the Pokebank. Or Pokemon Home now. Since they're not working on the 3DS anymore. They would need to have the Sinnoh remakes to be able to transfer all the previous gens, including all the previous gens, up to 5, to there. I think plus, at least up past to, up to like Gen 4. And put it into Gen 5. And I don't know if they're going to let Galarian in there or Alolan forms go in there. I'm not sure what features they're going to do for the previous ones, but they at least for the older generation Pokemon, they have to find a way to let people use them in their Pokebanks.
Well, here's where it gets interesting. It's an entirely new company doing this.
It is, and I'm not too fond of the chibi style myself personally. I think it's kind of weird. But the fact that they brought back Pokeball stickers makes me really happy. No, and then whatever statues you have in your base turns it into a Pokemon Underground of what you have in there. So you can have different things in there. Which is actually pretty sick. Okay, so I have pulled out of this. So. Nope. I have a Weasel in an inner tube.
That is, if you get another one, I need it, because that's cute.
I have a very angry Shinx.
Oh, why is he, oh, okay.
Because he's angry. A coughing. I have like 3 of these now. Another Trapinch, my favorite ground type. So
really?
Yes, Trapinch, the Trapinch line is actually one of my favorite ground types. Because Flygon is a beast.
I can respect that.
Okay, I have a
Well, that face says a lot right there.
You'll see in a minute.
So,
of a Rowlet.
You have Smart Bird.
I love Rowlet.
You have College Bird.
I have College Bird. Okay, what are you? Oh yeah, you're the rare. I have a Ooh, I like the texture of this card. I have a shiny Poltergeist.
Oh, you got one of the Shining Vaults Pokemon.
Mm-hmm. The card?
Good.
The texture on this card feels different from the other ones. It feels very scritchy.
So the process for that is similar to the process that was used on the etched foils for MTG. That is, they basically etched foiling or cold foiling is the new hot treatment to do.
Yeah, I have a shiny Poltegeist. Which is cool. That's cool. That's why I was like, I have a... My other rare is your favorite. I wish this was a shiny.
Hi, BB! I don't care. Makes me happy to see it. Love Celebi.
It's your baby.
Celebi's cool, yo.
I have a Rusted Shield. For Zonazenta. I ever get that. Oh, yeah, okay, so it's an attachment item. Zamazenta V, this card is attached to you, gets 70 plus 70 HP. Oh, that's cool.
Oh, God. Okay.
An Eldegoss. And a Dartrix. So I'm missing I'm missing Rabbitohead at this point. I think that's what I named my bird. I think that's what I named Decidueye, was Robin Hood.
I saw a big Pangoro out in the wild. I'm like, let's not!
The Dawn says no.
Yeah, I'm saying no. I'm giving him a wide berth of 5 zip codes, okay?
Oh my god.
Have you seen that mug? I'm not gonna mess with that.
Did you see what he's gonna do to you? He's gonna wreck you.
Him looking at me scares me. All I'm right. Saying no.
Another. This guy.
Before we get onto that pack.
Yes.
I need to go check on the dog. Give me a moment.
I shall. Gotta check. I will struggle to open this while you go check on the Sophie buttons. I love how he calls her buttons. As I struggle to all my heart's content to open this pack. Oh my god. Why? Oh my lord and savior, I cannot open this to save my ass. I want to get a hollow shiny Diglett. Shiny Diglett's cool. Our card guy that we go to at Frank and Sons has a shiny Ditto. I love that guy. I gotta wait for him to come back, and this card is adorable. It's just so. I can't believe that if it's cute or if it's just. He's just so silly looking, and it's adorable at the same time. Where it left off at. I don't know how that happened, but let's just quickly go through what I had pulled again. Because for some reason my recording stopped, which now makes me very paranoid of when did it stop. Now I gotta go find it. Like, ugh. Huh? Oh no.
Hold on.
Oh no. Oh no. I'm upset. No. Oh, there's a couple in here. I'm just gonna have to, like, mash them together or figure out where it was and then cut and paste them together in DaVinci. So I'm not really too worried about it because I'm actually pretty good at, I'm not saying I'm really good at video editing, but I've actually gotten pretty good at it. Somewhat. I'm not sure what changed, but it's not bad. But, hold on, so... Choodle. More Pico. Coughing. Gossifleur. Rowlet. Now, what I was laughing at earlier was the fact that I saw the corner of the rare that I had in this pack, and I started laughing. because I didn't mean to see the corner. I didn't see what it was, but I knew what the foiling was, and I started busting my ass off laughing. You'll see why. The Rotom is a reverse holo. I love this little guy. I think he's kind of cute. What I'm laughing at is the Rainbow Rare fucking Morpeko. I have two Rainbow Rares in my bag. It's not a shiny Morpeko either, which is kind of sad, but whatever. It's still a Rainbow Rare. I think it's a Rainbow Rare. Yeah, it is a Rainbow Rare. You could just... It's does it. The foiling on this is really cool, but yeah, that's a Rainbow. In E4. Just... Holy shit. Holy shit. Why are we doing this? Just... And then Chris started laughing. And then said Sashu. So we got some more Dark Energy. Another Luxio. Favorite Gen 5 electric type. He was cool. Team Yeltal. And another Thwacky. Thwacky's a Thwacky. When my roommate said he had a Thwacky, and I didn't know what the evolutions were for the second stage for the new starters, he goes, Thwacky's a Thwacky's a Thwacky. I'm like, the fuck's a Thwacky? And he goes, Thwacky's a Thwacky. And I'm like, oh my god. And then I figured out it was a fucking monkey. Like, oh, that's a Thwacky. Like, eh.
Actually, all this pack on me is making me want to open something.
I'm sorry. I'm not trying to make you open something. I just promised Sean that I would open it when he was here. And I decided to make a recording out of it, because I haven't done that in a while, and I'm pretty sure some people would like to actually see what Rogue Blackwell looks like. Don't all hold your applause at once, trust me. This isn't anything. It's just a very tired 30-year-old. Very depressed, tired 30-year-old. Oh, another Kufant. I wish I had, like, another camera that was, like, down. But... Kufant! Spinarak. Another I just saw what my next reverse holo is, and it made me happy, because I suck at holding the cards sometimes, but I know what it is, and I'm excited, and I'm happy, because this is my favorite, one of my favorite legendaries, and I'm happy right now. And if John, you should know me by now, you know what it is. Don't say it, though. There's Snum Nom. Horsey. Another And the rare is a reverse holo Manaphy! Look how cute she is! Look how cute he is! Look at it! I love him! 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 I love him so much! I love Manaphy! It's just, oh my god, so cute! So stinking cute! I love it! Love it so much! Are you even paying attention now?
I'm here.
I know you are, but where is he?
Mm-hmm.
Did he say he was gonna be AFK?
No.
I swear, if he just randomly left, I'm gonna slap him. I also got a normal holo Rillaboom. Oh, I got the really cool foiling in the back, the striped one. This is different from the normal one that I'm used to seeing. So that's really cool. It almost looks like he's 3D almost when he does that. That's actually kind of sick. Sean missed my Manaphy. Bullethead. Psychic energy.
It
was good to have.
You recorded it. He'll see it later.
No, I'll show it to him later. Oh, hey. Gym trainer. Then I got a Floatzel. Show you in a minute, once this card stays still. My Floatzel. And this time, instead of the Rusted Shield, I got a sword. What does this one do? Okay, so... the Zacian Z... The attacks of the Zacian Z this card's attached to do 30 more damage to your opponent's active opponent before applying weakness and resistances. So the sword gives Zamazenta more health. The shield gives Zamazenta more health. The sword gives Zacian gives it more attack power, which is pretty sick.
I hope this thing didn't crash.
I hope it didn't either.
I can't tell because we're not in another Discord.
No, but I don't know where he is though. This booger. He didn't text me and tell me he was gonna be AFK. Let me poke him. Like, the hell did you go? I'm like, dude, the fuck did you go? Where you be? You're missing all the good stuff. Open it. Oops. I'm trying to open it in a way so it actually doesn't rip the thing. This is where tweezers come in handy. I'm trying to be able to let it go back inside and, you know, be able to put it back inside the bag, because I want to keep it all, like, nice and, you know, pristine. You know, even though some of the cards are, like, common worthless penny cards, I still want to keep my cards. Okay, so, coughing. Again, obviously that's a common. Another Marpeko. Another Horsey. Spinarak. Now I know what I did. Because I did it, and I'm glad I caught it. I hit the space bar. The space bar stops me from recording. Good thing I caught that really quickly when I saw it. So I gotta avoid the space bar. Oh, shit. Nice. Rowlet. My rare... I have two rares. But my rare is a shiny Barrascuda. Pretty fucking sick. And then I have another foil Indeedee. I think that's the male one. Can't tell. But yeah, that's Indeedee. I know it is the male. I think the females have the little horns on their head, like, turned down. Flying energy. Or no. That's not flying. Duh. That's fighting.
Flying energy.
Yeah, okay. Flying energy. Yeah, flying's a fist. Your fist of flying. Another Dark Trix. We have an Eldegoss. And a Gym Trainer. That's really cool. I got a shiny Barrascuda. I'm getting shinies. That's really cool. I love the concept of Pokemon shinies, honestly, because it's just like, they're so rare, and it's just a mutation in the wild. Like, just like how some animals are either or albino, or melanistic. Or have, you know, very interesting things. And I absolutely love it. It's cool. It's cool! I can't believe I have two freaking Rainbow Rares in my pack, and one of them is a shiny. That's just... So, yeah, Chris, pat yourself on the back because you did it.
We're not done yet.
I know, we're not done yet. And actually, this is my second to last pack for Shining Fates. So, let's hope we get something good, even though pretty much I think the good stuff is already in the last two. That last card. So, another Snom Nom. Little Simon buddy. Horsey. Let's get my fat finger. A Rowlet. Morpeko again. Same thing, really. Spinarak. I have another reverse holo Morpeko. And then I have a holo Thievul. Which is cool, actually. I really like Thievul. I love Nickit and Thievul. It's really, they're really fun Pokemon. I thought they were the cutest thing ever. Grass Energy. Another Thwacky. Tropius. And Gym Trainer card. So, getting some good stuff. I like all the holos that I'm getting. That Barrowscoot was cool, though. It was a shiny. Okay. Last pack for the Shining Fates. Again, thank you for joining the Shining Fates. Don't worry, we still have a couple more for Evolving Woods. I have like 1, 2, 3, 4.
Evolving Skies.
5 Evolving Skies. I'm sorry. Evolving Skies, bleh. Do that. I'll probably do what I pull on the packs for TCG in a little bit later, and that way we'll see what I get for that. Since I'm going to use the a lot of codes to activate. Okay, so Cheap Tools, Mr. Bitey.
Sorry about that. I had to pat baby sister on the back because she came home from a very hard day at Fleming's, but she did very, very well.
And you didn't tell us that you were going AFK.
I did, and no one paid attention.
I didn't hear you, actually.
We didn't hear you
at
all.
We didn't hear you. Nobody heard you. Like, at least I didn't. But anyway,
Oh, well.
I got some
good... goods.
Okay, so third to last pack had a reverse holo Manaphy. I was happy.
I meant to show him the card.
Oh, okay, yeah, I can do that too. Let me finish this current pack and I'll show him what he missed. Coughing. This is the last pack right now, by the way. Okay. Gossifleur. A Rowlet. Ooh, hey, check it out. God damn it, Chris.
Yes. What? No!
Yes.
Show it. Well, yes. I'm glad I'm back at this time, because now we get to... The fact that your face gets to be recorded like this, this is the best part, is just you have such... Oh, your reactions are so pure. I love this.
Well, first, reverse holo Rillaboom. I have a card like this already. Actually, I have this card... That I think.
Yep, you have the normal version, don't you?
I do, but there's another one I see that I pulled. No, Chris. Rainbow Rare Haunted Freaking. Whatever you call those things.
VMAX. Anchors.
Delamise. Rainbow Rare VMAX Delamise. That's
three
Rainbow Rares in this fucking box. One of them being the shiny Toxicity. Three. Let Mikey know. Three Rainbow Rares. I'll bring it to him next time we go.
Okay.
But three, Chris.
Yes.
It's hard. Gym Trainer. Luxio and Dartrix. And that is all the rest of Shining Fates with three Rainbow Rares. One being the shiny Toxicity card that I got, VMAX card. But three Rainbow Rare VMAX Pokemons. Are you kidding me right now?
That was good.
This is what Chris does. He taps things and things happen. He touches them. All he has to do is just touch it and you get like his good karma or something. No, it doesn't work on him for some reason. We don't know why. We wish we knew why. Okay, so I think it was the last two packs that had some of the really good stuff in it. I won't show you the comments. I'll go straight for the rares that you missed. Shiny Barrascoota.
Oh, that's the Vaults one.
Mm-hmm. And a holo Indeedee.
That's actually a really cool... Oh, the cracked ice foil. Yeah, that's a nice
one. I got a couple of cracked ice foils. That's what I was running. I was like, what is that called for the foil? Like, what is it? Cracked something? Like, I couldn't remember what that foiling was called.
It's got such a weird name, so I don't blame you.
I just couldn't remember it, because I know it was different from the other foiling. Kind of makes them look like they're like have like a 3D kind of animation to it.
See, that's why I like it, too.
Okay, and then I have another reverse holo Morpeko and a cracked ice holo Beeble. And then
this den had a nugget in it.
Yay.
He's so happy with himself. Also, Sean, I figured out what happened with that other recording because I ended up doing it again, but I noticed it like within a minute. I hit the space bar. Apparently hitting space bar stops me from recording.
What?
I don't know. Also, please forgive the mess of my room. Actually, it's kind of clean now that I made my bed, so it's not as disgustingly gross.
Not as bad as it could be.
My room's not that messy.
No, like... Like, that's how I would treat it. It's like, I mean, it's not as bad.
It's not as bad as what it could be. I mean, I'm not really a messy person in my room anyway, so... Okay, so here's the one that I was freaking out about, besides the rainbow freaking rare.
your cherished Pokemon.
She was talking about, like, oh, this is, like, the Pokemon I always wanted. Sean knows it, and then he doesn't get a response back from Sean.
And I'm like, oh, fuck, did this guy go? Reverse holo Manaphy, my cherished Manaphy, my love for Manaphy is pretty much your love for Celebi. And I love it so much. And then that Rillaboom card. You know how I have the reverse holo? Now I have an ice foil of this one. See how I said that? It looks like it has like a 3D kind of animation going on.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool. Yeah, that was what you missed.
That's pretty good.
But three.
You missed the deets.
Yeah, you missed the
deets. Deeper.
You missed the deets. But yeah, that was my box of Shining Fates. I have three rainbow rares in this box. It was pretty good.
Yeah. I think pretty good only scratches the surface of how good.
I mean, they're not that freaking shiny Charizard V card that's, like, fucking expensive, but...
$146.
Jesus.
Dude.
I'm not really into it to really make money, honestly. I'm just into it just to rebuild my fucking collection back.
Oh, for me, it's just like, okay, cool, let's do something where we could wax on about 25 years of Pokemon, things we liked about it, things we haven't liked about it, that kind of thing.
I mean, obviously, we can also go into, like, when we started our Pokemon journey, because when Celebrations comes out, I'm going to try to get a thing for it. He has my Evolving Skies Elite Box with my Umbreon in it. I'm Umbreon chasing. At least I'm trying. I do want that card, but it's a rare freaking card, and there are two other Umbreon cards that I can have to make my Umbreon themed up.
Surprise, Michelle. It's in my box.
It's going to be so in your box. It's going to be in your box. Okay, so now we have five... Evolving Skies. Two of them have the Umbreon on it for the cover. Those are last because Umbreon's my favorite. My favorite evolution is my Shadow Boy. So we're gonna go with Duraludon. See what goods we got. And this is fun as hell. So I like opening. I never really thought about doing card pack openings, and I know like I should be doing a lot more game playthroughs, but with work and everything popping up, I just haven't had time to really do it, and this is why I don't do this as a profession. Because I have an inconsistent streaming fucking... My streaming schedule is so inconsistent, I just do it on a whim. I never plan to do this, like, professionally or anything. I just do it on a whim. That's why when I first got into it, it was on a whim. I'm like, I'm just gonna do this because I feel like it. And just because it's something new. And it gives me something to do during COVID. Okay, so we got Dian... this pupkaboo. Dino dinosaur. A claymation pumpkaboo. I love it.
I love it.
I love the claymation style. Sometimes they're just funny looking. Carvana. I never really liked that Pokemon. I'm not a big fan of Sharpedo. Another Gossifleur. One of my favorite Fletchling. I just got a reverse holo card for Raihan. Freaking Bay over here. Everybody loves him. Oh, speaking of the card that I said, the Pokemon that I said I did not like, they're Sharpedo.
Nyaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaaa
I have a Zwei list for my DNOs now. I have Copycat. And a different art color of Xenia's Resolve.
Hold on. You just pulled a Copycat?
Yeah, Copycat.
1 second.
Is this a good one or something? Shuffle your hand into your deck, then draw a card for each card in your opponent's hand. That's pretty cool. So.
Okay, hold on.
Also, there is a Xenia's Resolve that has a different art than this.
There's a few of them.
Yeah.
Copycat also has a different art.
Did I get the one with a different art?
Let me see it. I don't believe you did. Okay, no.
That's the regular one.
But I have Xenia's Resolve. Hello, Xen. Alright, so nothing really in this. Oh, well, other than the reverse holo Raihan trainer card. Because everybody likes Raihan. Everybody ships Raihan with Leon, which is fucking fangirls.
In the words of Yami from the Yu-Gi-Oh! Abridged series, fangirls ruin everything. Yes.
I only ruin some things just because I have... Everybody has theirs, and I have mine. But we're gonna go into that. Gilgamesh. Sorry, I had a cough in my throat.
I have not had this much fun playing a Pokemon game in a while. This is this is kind of great.
I actually didn't I know a lot of people there's like for like that game and the last like two gens, I didn't really have a problem with it because there were some things that could have been a little different. This one definitely shouldn't have like trimmed the Pokédex list, and I'm not sure why they did it. And honestly, when they came out with those expansions and they let some other mon in, I had a feeling that they would do that, but it's like, honestly, I never really had a problem with it. I don't really have... I'm just playing it for the fun and the nostalgia. I'm not playing it for competitive or EV breeding train because I didn't really get into that as a kid because I didn't know about that as a kid, and I was like 10 when I got my Pokemon Yellow. So I started late in that game, and it's like, I never really paid attention to it until, you know, now that I'm a little bit older. Sometimes I try to do a little bit of the... you know, shiny training, the shiny hunting, and, you know, trying to fix the Pokédex. Like, technically, actually, if it was Shield, that it was the first time I ever finished an entire Pokédex in a game, in a mainstream game. And it's like, I wasn't trying to play it for that kind of thing, and I don't know why people, like, get mad at it or how it sucks. Yes, honestly, I think the graphics could have been a little bit different, because look at Breath of the Wild, and then look at, like, the trees in there. Yeah, I can see why people get pissed. That's why I'm a little worried about Legends of Arceus, because I really want to play that game. But the graphics still look pretty jaggy, but it still looks really fun to play, and I really, really want to play it. It's like, ugh.
It's like you guys made a lot of promises, and you kind of got to start delivering.
Yeah, you really got to start delivering, especially with the 25th anniversary of you guys making it all about Sinnoh. And honestly, I feel like I'm still am gonna buy Legends of Arceus, much to probably my roommate's chagrin, and he's probably gonna like give me crap for it. But I just want to play it because it looks like fun. I'm not in it for the stupid graphics. I don't care. I'm blind as fuck anyway. So I
price for the 25th, they didn't release Pokemon Red and Blue Revisioned or something.
Dude, you're kind of not wrong on that.
Maybe Chris should go work for Game Freak or the Pokemon Company.
If you're gonna celebrate a 25th anniversary, that sounds like the right way to do it. Honestly,
I really love this puppy. Rockruff is cute. I like Lycan rocking over the Rockruff is just adorable. So this is adorable as a Growly. Weesimer, that's crying.
You can't compare it to Growlithe, at least not in my opinion.
Yeah, whatever.
But Boof Puppy.
I know Boof Puppy.
Or, you know, Yamper.
Okay, stupid fucking Yamper, I love that thing. I'm so
Show me your war face.
His sentient pile of garbage, I don't know why that exists, and I think it's stupid. I always love playing...
We have Klefki, shush.
Hey, Boo Boo Keys is amazing, shut up. I know they're only doing a remake, but I'm wondering for the next mainline series what the next inanimate object's gonna be, because we already have a haunted tea kettle and the teacup.
I like that it's antiques and we got a ghost type out of it. That was kinda neat.
I like the fact that there is one that's actually the original, and then the other ones that have the stamps on them are copies. Like, it's an actual real antique, and the other ones are copies.
Yeah, you have antiques and fate in the...
I like that.
I mean, I'm like, that's clever.
It's Yenimo. Freaking Lamprey. Thing evolves into a Lamprey. Thing is ugly. I hate... Clobopus. It's so happy that it's gonna punch you in the face. Hey... Reverse Holo Electrode. My other rare that I got in this is a Shedinja.
That's kind of cool.
It is kind of cool. I didn't know the only way to really get a Shedinja was to evolve the Ninjask and have an empty slot in your inventory. I never knew that. Lightning. Telescopic sight. And you have Marina. And Charmeek. Yes, and alright, that's two. No, I'm not exactly. Oh, this was my Vivid Voltage back. Excuse me, that's right, I got a Vivid Voltage. This wasn't the Rolling Skies. I wanted to fetch you. Ah! See? I'm dropping shit. So technically, I only had four Evolving Skies and one Vivid Voltage, and then I had a Battle Styles that Monkey gave me for the fun of it. Same game, I was like, here. I hope you get something good out of it. He just tossed it at me and then said, hey, you want cards? Can you play the only game you have? Here, have codes. You're not superstitious, are you? No.
Why do they have to make such cute art for Glaceon?
Because Glaceon's adorable. At least now I'm gonna have Evolving Sky Packs when I put the cards in.
Dude, some of this stuff is jumping up to
Skyduck. I think that's Clay. Actually, he's not a Clay one. He just looks like a real life name, but he kind of looks like a Clay one.
It's almost like a weird cell shade kind of thing.
Yeah, it is. Rufflet. BB Burb. American Burb.
I like Rufflet.
Drowsy. Flabébé.
They made that Pokemon in its arc way too depressing when it was introduced. Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Ragnarola. I have another reverse holo Raihan. I have a Drampa, and this thing scares me. I think something pissed it off. Like, holy hell, pissed it off.
This is why you don't bug Grandpa before he has his coffee.
Yeah, really, don't bug the Drampa before it's had its coffee. Fire energy. Avalug. Almost dropping that too. Vigoroth. And a Dream Ball. So, woo. Put this back and open the leader. Gonna go order that.
So I already figured out the thing that I'm gonna be getting next.
Thing? You're thinking of a thing? What is this thing that you speak of? Please share with the class. Okay, the two Umbreons. Give me luck, please.
Even if you get any of the alternate Umbreons,
I just want an Umbreon card so I can be very happy with what I'm going to build with it.
Just because it's Umbreon and that's kind of like your baby.
Oh, Umbreon's been my baby since I found it in Gen 2. When I had Gen 2 and Umbreon came out, I'm like, I love it. I love him so much.
Incidentally, you could get a Garbodor VMAX in this thing. Don't ask why he's in there to troll you, but he is.
Oh, I swear to God, he comes out in any of these packs, I'm just gonna burn it. I hate Garbodor. Like, why do we need a sentient bag of trash? Does not make any sense. Okay. Do this, I need to take a little break, and then we can put the codes in. And then I have to do... I have to go do some dishes. Litnio. Shinku. I like Shinshu. I don't know if it's Shinku or Chincho. I never could really pronounce it.
I was never fond of it just because of typing. I was kind of a stickler on that.
I have a second one. Do you want it?
Yeah, I'm a sucker for claymation. All
right.
The claymation look is kind of cool.
Hey. I have a Rapid Strike Reverse Holo Feebas. I love my...
Cool, now get the Milotic.
Great. I have a Gorgeist from my Pumpkaboo.
Yay!
Yay!
I mean, that means that was your rare.
Yeah, after. It was. Yeah, because the Feebas is a common.
Well, no, that... Okay, so... The reverse holo slot could be any rarity.
Oh, okay.
The card after it is guaranteed rare at the minimum.
So, I had a water energy card. Another Zinnia's Resolve.
Turns out that's actually a really good card.
Hippodon for my Hippopotas. And a Tentacruel.
Okay.
So I got a reverse holo. I mean, it could be any. As you said, it could be any slot, but I mean, it's cool. I got a shiny card. I'm a sucker for shiny, because I swear to God, I have like 80 OS, which is a type of shit ooh shiny. So. Doesn't really bother me. Okay, last Evolving Skies. You all for joining me on this awesome pack uncarding of good stuff. The rest of the fun will come when I am done with finishing the dishes. Because I will put the codes in on the TCG player.
And hey, it's thank you for hosting us.
Yeah. Thank you all for being here for my little fun little idea, because now I like to do more card openings. Except I'm not exactly very well known, so I can never get money for these.
My audio's in this, yeah?
Always, yeah. My audio, everybody's in this. Ha ha! Applin'.
Well, I was going to say, thanks everyone for joining us through this little nostalgia trip. We're going to have several more of these because, you know, that's the crime of our age is being suckers for nostalgia.
Oh, yeah.
Like Dunkaroos and Tamagotchis.
I miss my Tamagotchi. The fact that I bought an Angel Gotchi off of, like, eBay was really cool because I didn't even know an Angel Gotchi existed. I just missed my Tama. Now I want to get the fake Go Tamagotchi from Japan. So I can have my very own pocket Gilgamesh and watch him call me Zashu. Or have a pocket Ku. Because Lanza. I don't want a pocket saber. She'll be too expensive and I have to give her a burger every time.
Every time you drive past a Burger King, you must suffer and pay a dollar.
Mm-hmm. Emolga. I love the little flying squirrel. I loved Emolga. Yeah, little flying squirrel was cute.
I'm sad they didn't give it an evolution and made it more powerful.
Yeah. Tentacruel. Another punkaboo.
Okay, so I have to ask. Do we actually have a cute electric rodent in Sword and Shield, or do we just have the cute electric mascot here?
I love... Morpeko was the cute electric mascot. It's a freaking...
I thought it was
It's a bipolar hamster.
And... Okay.
Yeah, it's a hangry bipolar hamster.
Fuck it. Wonderful.
Have you seen it? No, Morpeko...
Why does it...
Morpeko
why does it
was... Morpeko was Sword and Shield's Pikachu.
Why does it have to be bipolar?
Because it's hangry.
Okay.
Why do I have to be bipolar? Haha! Child trauma. A reverse holo Hitmonchan... He's a common, so. My rare is the Stoutland.
Yay.
And his majestic freaking mustache. I have a Leaf Energy. My uncommon is a Pyroar, so my Litleo that I pulled in the other pack has a Pyroar to go with it. Dream Ball. And a Bulldoor. I'm not sure what exactly, other than the Umbreons, and like, other than like Umbreon and shit in this pack, I'm not sure what exactly Evolving Skies has to pull in it that people are looking for other than the Flarts. I have to look at it, but I want more Evolving Sky packs.
Other than Flarts?
Other than Flarts, like what is Evolving Skies? I really have to look at like what Evolving Skies has in it that people want besides that.
Dragons.
Dragons, really?
Well, the biggest draw you are looking for,
yeah,
and you'll know when you see it, it's a unique as hell Rayquaza.
Oh, the Rayquaza, that's right.
You will know when you see it, because
like,
boy does it stand out.
It's like, holy shit. Is it a shiny Rayquaza or no?
Secret art. Valued at $350 current market price.
That secret art Umbreon too, the one that looks like he's trying to get the moon, bop it like a dumbass. That's like over $300-something for it too. Like,
nope, it plummeted to $240.
It was $300 when last I was looking at it on TCG Player.
That was during pre-release numbers.
It dropped.
Of course it did.
Of course it did. It's just like what Magic does.
Anything. Like, hey, we're past pre-release, so guess what?
Things are going to drop because people are pulling them. I have 3 rainbow rares. I should post those on TCG Las Vegas. Be like, yeah, I'm from California. This is what I pulled.
No.
You get the banhammer then.
How's
that a banhammer? Like, this is what I got.
Because you're posting from out of state. No one gives a damn.
You're being very... It makes you seem obnoxious.
I am obnoxious.
It is, quote, humble bragging, and no one likes that.
Yeah, well, I'm just gonna wiggle over here and... Another thing, like, they really deck you out with these boxes, too. Like, they give you codes and stuff. I have more codes. Like, good lord. And
yeah, you know, you think WotC and the Hasbro lawyers would have learned with MTG by now, and like, man, Pokemon does really well with this. They're getting a lot of success with this. Maybe we should try it too.
I'm assuming this is a poison counter, but I'm not sure what this one is. Is this like a damage counter or something like that?
Confused or knockout?
Maybe.
Because those are supposed to be condition markers.
And then, you know, it gives you Eevee sleeves.
Well, it gives you matching sleeves for whatever box you got.
Yeah. Which is, I might use these for my Umbreon deck. Not sure.
Those sleeves are always terrible. Art is good, but the sleeves are garbo.
Really? That bad? Oh, these are little dividers.
You could blame Brian at Talarian Community College for reviewing them.
Oh, bag of energy, which is actually really cool. It's like Magic's bag of mana.
Oh, the land pack.
The only thing I really, really enjoy about that, the theme dice, are Eevee colors. I love it. I love it a lot. I love it. I love it a lot. I love it. I love it a lot. I'm not sure what this dice is supposed to do. I don't really understand the dice very well. But
well, instead of flipping a coin all the time, it's basically a heads-tails marker, too.
Oh, the dice? Really?
Odds and evens, damn it.
Oh, okay. I get it. Yeah, I mean, that could do that.
Plus, if you try and etch special designs on coins, they're not necessarily always perfectly weighted to come up evens and tails half the time, so...
And then the damage dice on mine, it's just, it's really cool. They deck you out with the boxes that are really, really nice. Oh, and then the, obviously the special card that came in here was obviously the full VMAX Eevee. It wasn't a rainbow or anything. I don't know if that one could have been.
Nope.
So it was just a normal VMAX.
That one's fixed.
That one's fixed. You're just so happy about that. Like, haha. That just... This was the good one, but the fact that I got more rainbow rares is just ridiculous. And then the Cinderace.
Yay.
Which is really cool.
Did you get any Eevees, Michelle?
No, I didn't. Well, so Chrissy just revealed who Roblackwell was. Which is funny. Yes, my real name is.
Well, you keep using our names too,
yeah,
so you know.
I kind of forgot, but I mean, I don't think anybody.
You can blot out the last few minutes of this.
I don't think anybody really gives a damn.
You're supposed to.
You're supposed to. Care, dang it.
I can't care enough.
I would like my name to be stricken off the video, please. Thank you.
Same.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, I was gonna go through this anyway, but I'm pretty much done with this.